Hyperbion was among the chosen few of Phoebus, and men honored him a while, honoring in him the god. But others sang as loudly, and the boys as loudly cheered Hyperbion, more than bard should be, was wroth, and thus he spake to Phoebus, "Hearest thou, O Phoebus? The rude rabble from the field, who swear that they have known thee ever since thou feddest for Admetos his white bull. I hear them," said the god. "Seize thou the first and haul him up above the heads of men, and thou shalt hear them shout for thee as please." Headstrong and proud Hyperbion was. The crown of laurel on it badly curled his brow so, when he heard them singing at his gate, while some with flints cut there the rival's name, rushing he seized the songster at their head. The songster kicked and struggled hard. In vain Hyperbion clasped him round with arm robust, and with the left a hempen rope uncoiled, whereon already was a noose. It held the calf until the mother's teat was drawn at morn and eve. And both were now afield. With all his strength he pulled the wretch along, and hauled him up a pine tree where he died. But one night, not long after, in his sleep he saw the songster. Then did he beseech Apollo to enlighten him, if perchance in what he did he had done aught amiss. "Thou hast done well, Hyperbion," said the god, "as I did also to one Marsyas some years ere thou wert born, but better 'twere if thou hadst understood my words aright, for those around may harm thee, and assign as reason that thou wentest past the law. My meaning was that thou shouldst hold him up in the high places of thy mind, and show thyself the greater by enduring him." Downcast Hyperbion stood, but Phoebus said, "Be of good cheer, Hyperbion. If the rope is not so frayed but it may hold thy calf, the greatest harm is that by hauling him thou hast chafed, sorely, that old pine, and pine tree bark will never close again.